The following program is produced by Laura K. Henderson, Michael Ray Helms, and Jen Heben under the direction of executive producer Laura K. Henderson and the board of All Ears Theater, with funding provided by the Irving S. Gilmore Foundation, David Isaacson, and Laura and Elisa Whiteford. All Ears Theater. Do you recall the ghost stories told to you by candlelight as a child? Then sit back and listen as we take you once again to those dark nights with our telling of The Legend of Sleepy Hollow, written by Deborah Hanley from the classic Washington Irving short story. Featured in the cast are Mickey Sykes, Glynis Fenn, Ben Hooper, Jen Heaven, Rebecca Vave, Tim Eschelbach, Sarah Lynn Roddis, and Dustin Mortin.
If you should ever wish for a retreat from the world and its distractions, there is no valley more promising than that of Sleepy Hollow and the nearby village of Tarrytown. I know the area intimately, for my family has lived in the valley for three generations. Although it seemed to be an ordinary place as a child, I now know with an adult perspective that childhood is not meant to be haunted by gory visions and bewitching legends.
Bessie, you are a fine mare and a friendly companion, but you provide a most uncomfortable ride. My backside is suffering from your sagging midsection. Oh, there's thunder in the distance. I look forward to ending this journey and starting my position as schoolmaster of Tarrytown. I sense a dreamy influence in this valley, Bessie. It pervades the very atmosphere of the forest. What was that? Who's there? Show yourself! Show yourself, I say! The wind is playing tricks on me. It is no trick. We're surrounded by forest nymphs. Stay away. Get up, Bessie. I say get!
And there goes our brave new schoolmaster, Mr. Ichabod Crane.
He rides as if he was chased by a spirit.
I can still see him on the horizon. Goodness, he is a tall fellow.
And exceedingly skinny. If he turned sideways, he would disappear.
Aye, he is loosely strung together. He looks like a scarecrow escaped from the cornfield.
Did you see those huge ears and long nose?
And spindly neck. His head would make a good weather vane on a windy day.
Claire, Jacob said the new schoolmaster was chosen because he's cruel and quick with a rod.
Oh, Emma, your brother tells stories to scare the youngins. Time will tell us if he is cruel. But at present, we already know he's afraid of girls. That storm is still a ways off.
Mama says there's a ghost that haunts the glen at Raven Rock, and she screams before a storm because she was lost and perished in a terrible snow squall.
Oh, I have heard the same story. We need to get home before the storm arrives.
I've picked all the berries I can manage. Let us walk to the clearing and part ways at the crossroad.
Agreed.
According to country custom, the schoolmaster was lodged at the houses of the farmers whose children he instructed. He lived with each family a week at a time, making the rounds with all his worldly effects tied up in a cotton handkerchief. He was especially pleased to be invited to dinner where the mother was noted for the comforts of the cupboard, and his pupil happened to have a pretty older sister.
I can assure you, Mr. VonTassel, I do my disciplinary duty as schoolmaster. I prefer to administer justice with discrimination rather than severity.
Yes, well, you have the full support of Sleepy Hollow's school parish, Mr. Crane.
Thank you, Mr. VonTassel. Ah, Mrs. VonTassel, this pheasant is sumptuous, and the pudding is divine.
Oh, thank you, schoolmaster. You are a huge feeder for such a lanky fellow. But the credit for the pudding goes to Katrina. I have taught her the arts of homemaking, and she is a quick student.
Oh, Mama, don't!
Oh, if we could only say the same about her mathematics skills.
What do you mean, Mr. VonTassel?
Katrina falls short in mathematics.
Papa! She does struggle with her sums, schoolmaster. master.
And her fractions.
Yes, and both are necessary to properly run a household.
Excuse me, am I not here in this room with you?
Mr. VonTassel, Mrs. VonTassel, I believe Katrina was done a disservice by the previous schoolmaster. She was not taught the basics from which she could build a good foundation.
Could you teach her those basics, Mr. Crane?
Why, yes, indeed. I believe I could.
Oh, then we must set up a tutoring schedule while you are here.
That would be most prudent, Mrs. VonTassel.
Huh, very prudent.
What was that, Katrina?
Nothing, Papa.
We are so fortunate to have a devoted schoolmaster in Sleepy Hollow once again.
And I am fortunate to have such a lovely pupil, whose parents are interested in the scholarly pursuits of their only daughter.
Yes, we are all fortunate.
Mrs. VonTassel and I are hosting a harvest frolic on Saturday. All of Terrytown in the Hollow will be here. You can meet all the families of your pupils.
Splendid! I look forward to sampling the fine culinary creations of the VonTassel women once again.
Mm-hmm. Mother, we are ready for coffee.
Of course. Katrina, pour the coffee and I will bring the ginger cakes.
Yes, Mama.
Ginger cakes! Excellent!
Katrina VonTassel was a blooming lass of 19, famed for her beauty and her vast expectations. No doubt Ichabod Crane found Katrina and her father's farm equally enchanting. But there was a local adversary for Katrina's heart, a giant of a man named Brom Bones, and he was a formidable rival. Even a stouter man than Ichabod Crane would have been wise to withdraw from the competition for Katrina's affections.
His plate. Where in heaven's name does he put all that food?
His spirits rise with eating the way other men's do with women.
Oh, but I've heard he courts Katrina VonTassel of late, and I see him pass on the road most nights after school on his way to the VonTassel farm.
Yes, and Katrina says he always arrives at the dinner hour, so he is assured an invitation to supper.
I think he has his eye on Katrina and her father's farm.
Oh, he covets the farm, all right. When he passes her father's pig, he dreams of an apple in its mouth and pudding in its belly.
Oh, it cannot be easy to be a newcomer in Sleepy Hollow.
True, but our schoolmaster is doubly cursed. He also has an air of superiority that rubs every man he meets the wrong way.
Hey, schoolmaster!
Uh-oh, Brom Bones is tipsy with ale.
Schoolmaster, you eat more than Mr. VonTassel's sow.
Brom Bones, let the schoolmaster be. He's busy filling his hollow legs.
Good evening, Brom Bones. Captain.
You sure know how to put it away, schoolmaster. Oh, skinny as a rail with the dilating powers of an anaconda.
Eat up, Mr. Ichabod Crane. You'll need your strength for the long ride home tonight. I hear the horsemen ride through the hollow of late.
Who?
Our schoolmaster does not know about the horseman, Captain.
Oh, ho, ho, ho. With a horseman is a ghost who cradles his severed head in his arm as he rides. He tethers his horse in the graveyard, you know.
Sir, I am a master of Cotton's book on New England witchcraft. I am not afraid of a headless specter. Why, just last week, I stymied the mischievous pranks of some forest fairies by quoting from Cotton's book.
Ooh, a book won't save you from the headless horseman, schoolmaster. The horseman rides to collect souls. They say he tosses his severed head to a rider to knock him from his saddle.
Oh, you're scaring the schoolmaster, old man. The horseman only rides for sport, Mr. Crane. 2 nights ago, I was returning from the neighboring village when I was overtaken by the ghost. I offered to race him for a jug of ale, and I would have won it, too. But just as we came to the church bridge, the headless spirit and his goblin horse vanished in a flash of fire.
You tell a fine tale for children, Mr. Bones. I must remember it for story hour at school. Ooh, plum pudding on the corner table. Excuse me, sirs. I'm going to fill a bowl for myself before it is gone.
The youngins of Sleepy Hollow already know the story of the Headless Horseman well. You can be sure of that, schoolmaster.
Don't waste your breath on him, Captain. The man is a know-it-all pain in the hindquarters.
Ooh, and here comes your own Katrina VonTassel.
Bones, are you making sport of our schoolmaster?
Oh, Katrina, he doesn't need my help. He looks ridiculous all by himself.
I think he is handsome in his Sunday suit.
Ha! His hands dangle a mile below his sleeves.
He dances quite well.
What? Just look at him, Katrina. His elbows stick out like a grasshopper, and his arms flap like wings.
I admire his enthusiasm. And besides, I do not see you on the dance floor. I think I will have a dance with our schoolmaster. Good evening, Brom.
Good evening, Katrina.
Hello, Mr. Crane.
Oh, Miss VonTassel. Good evening.
I see you are enjoying the Widow Hornby's plum pudding.
Yes, it is delightful. Much better than that dried out baked squash on the neighboring table. I consider myself somewhat of a connoisseur, and between you and me, the squash would do better as chinking for log walls than dessert.
Oh, don't you just love a contra dance, Mr. Crane?
Oh, well, would you enjoy a dance, Miss VonTassel?
Certainly. Thank you.
Your dress is very pretty, Miss VonTassel.
Thank you.
Quite a fine fabric.
Yes. Mother says it is French woven.
And a pretty color.
Thank you. It's French dyed.
So, it is French made.
Yes, it's French.
Miss VonTassel, I would love to sample the dish you brought this evening.
I believe you already have, Mr. Crane. I brought the dried out baked squash.
Ooh.
Here. Let's have a real go at this tune, Katrina. Pardon us, schoolmaster.
But...
No, thank you, Brom. I have enjoyed our dance, Mr. Crane, but I have neglected my duties as hostess long enough. Mother needs me. Good evening, gentlemen.
Good evening, Miss VonTassel.
Good evening, Katrina. I have seen you riding to the VonTassel farm on that broken-down mare of yours. She looks to be at death's door. Can you coax her into a gallop?
If you are challenging me to a race, Mr. Bones, I concede at the starting line.
Where's the sport in that, schoolmaster?
Bessie has carried me faithfully for many years. I would not put her in jeopardy to satisfy a young man's whims.
Where are you from, Mr. Crane?
The state of Connecticut. I have traveled extensively in my years as a choir master and schoolmaster.
Oh, then Sleepy Hollow must seem ordinary to you, and the women uninteresting.
On the contrary, I find the women of Sleepy Hollow pleasant and most interesting.
And do their farmers' farms interest you too?
Are you speaking of Miss VonTassel, Mr. Bones?
Katrina and I have known each other a long time. She prefers a man who can ride and hunt and dance.
Ah, I was concerned for a minute. But, to my good fortune, Miss VonTassel has expressed her preference in dance partners this very evening.
Well, we'll see who Katrina prefers, Mr. Ichabod Crane.
Oh, hello, Brom. Oh, dear. Brom Bones looks upset, Mr. Crane.
Oh? I hadn't noticed, Mrs. VonTassel.
Well, you seem to be enjoying yourself anyway.
Yes, indeed. I understand why your autumn frolic is the highlight of the season. This is a veritable feast, madam. Oh,
thank you. It does a heart good to see a young man enjoy his food. I saw you dancing with our Katrina schoolmaster. You make a lovely couple on the dance floor.
Your observation means a great deal to me, Mrs. VonTassel. A great deal to me. Would you, Care to dance, madam?
Oh, thank you, schoolmaster. I would indeed.
Brom Bones was smitten with love and jealousy, and a feud gradually arose between him and Ichabod Crane. But because of the difference in their strength and stature, Brom Bones and his gang of Rough Riders were left with no alternative but to play practical jokes on his rival.
Class, take out your primers and begin the morning's grammar lesson. Quietly, class!
Schoolmaster, the smoke is not drying up the chimney.
Well, see, what is the matter, Emma?
Something has stuffed feed bags up the stack. It's completely blocked.
I can't breathe, Mr. Crane.
Oh, for heaven's sake. Take your overcoats and leave the schoolhouse in an orderly fashion. Blast you, Brom Bones, and your childish pranks!
Emma, it's just as I told you. Witches are holding their meeting in our schoolhouse at night.
Why would witches stop up the chimney?
Oh, I don't know. But Isaac said Mr. Crane tried to hide a mess the witches made 2 nights ago. Isaac said every desk was topsy-turvy when he arrived at school yesterday morning, and Mr. Crane made him straighten them up before he opened the schoolhouse doors.
Oh, dear. Yesterday, all the primers were placed on the shelf with their spines to the back and the pages facing out.
Poor Isaac got his hands whacked by the schoolmaster for that prank. But I know it was the witches' doing.
Why would witches use our primers?
Well, I don't know. Maybe they were writing a book of spells and wanted to check their grammar?
All right, I've aired out the schoolhouse. Return to your seats, everyone, and begin your lessons. No discussion and no slacking.
If only your witches had a spell for ridding us of know-it-all schoolmasters.
Crane fancied his singing voice, and he held a weekly singing school in the evenings at the church. As singing master, he was able to spend time with Katrina without the watchful eyes of her parents or Brom Bones looking on.
Very good, everyone. Katrina, lovely, lovely voice. That is enough for this evening. Next week, we'll start working on Christmas hymns. Good night, everyone. Katrina, may I walk you home?
I would like that very much, Mr. Crane. Isn't it a lovely evening, Mr. Crane?
Katrina, I would be very pleased if you called me by my first name, Ichabod.
Oh, but Mr. Crane, you are my singing master, and that would not be respectful.
Katrina, I hope that someday, soon, I can be much more than your singing master.
Oh, well, Ichabod, I look forward to the day when... Why, Brom Bones, I thought you were occupied with work tonight.
I changed my plans, Katrina. I am able to walk you home after all.
What a pleasant surprise. Thank you, Brom. I will take my leave now, Mr. Crane. Thank you, schoolmaster.
But, Katrina, I am going to walk you home. And please call me... Ichabod. Well, it appears her attentions to me are merely a sham.
Ichabod Crane was crestfallen over this change of events, but he continued to call on Katrina at the VonTassel farm, where he would tell fantastic stories from his native state of Connecticut, or describe fearful visions he saw in his nightly rides around Sleepy Hollow. But his efforts to woo Katrina were fruitless, and she remained unimpressed.
Bessie, old girl, I think Katrina used me for her conquest of Brom Bones. I had hopes of one day being lord of that splendid farm and all those roasted chickens and salted hams and platters of cakes and pies and... Who is there? I see someone mounted on a tall horse, but I cannot make him out. Sir, why do you not answer? Get up, Bessie. He does not appear a friendly sort. Day is done, but love unfailing dwells ever here. Shadows fall, but hope prevailing calms every fear. God our maker, none forsaking, take our hearts of love's own making. Watch our sleeping, God our waking, be always near. He is still behind us and matches his pace to ours. Stranger! I cannot see you! Why do you follow me at a distance? Sir, I demand you come out of the shadows and show your face! You have no face! You have no head! Oh, dear Lord! Bessie, save us from this phantom! Fly, Bessie! Fly! We must reach the church bridge! The phantom cannot cross the stream!
Is this the spot, Emma?
No, it's the other side of the bridge. This way. Here, this is where the headless horseman spirited away our schoolmaster.
How do you know?
They found the iron shoe that his horse threw right here. And the schoolmaster's hat was at the edge of the stream over there.
What was he doing here alone at night?
Mr. VonTassel said he often spoke of riding through the hollow late at night. He claimed his knowledge of Mr. Cotton's book of witchcraft gave him all the protection he needed.
Huh.
Come this way. Do you see that shattered pumpkin?
Uh-huh.
That's the spot where they found his book of witchcraft. It was trampled by the schoolmaster's horse.
Or the headless horseman's mount.
No, it was the schoolmaster's.
Now, Emma, how do you know that?
There was a horseshoe imprint on the leather cover. Phantom horses do not wear iron shoes.
Huh. Poor schoolmaster. Emma, let's leave this place. It gives me goosebumps, even in daylight.
This way.
Why, good morning, Constable Hudson.
Good morning, Mrs. VonTassel.
Do come in, sir.
Thank you. I've brought you a few personal items belonging to our former school... I mean, Mr. Ichabod Crane. I'm not aware of any relatives who might lay claim to them.
But why bring them here, Constable?
While going through his belongings, I found a journal, and there were many entries in his hand about suppers with your family. It appears you are the closest thing to a family that he had in Sleepy Hollow.
I see. Well, give them here, then.
A vest and collar, a hymnal, his journal, a broken pitch pipe, Cotton's book of New England witchcraft.
There's not much here in the way of possessions for a grown man.
No, ma'am. He expressed a fondness for your puddings and cakes in his journal, Mrs. VonTassel.
Yes, the man could eat more than all our farmhands put together. Well, thank you, Constable.
You are welcome, Mrs. VonTassel.
Who was that, Mama?
It was Constable Hudson. He gave me the schoolmaster's worldly possessions.
Why did he bring them to us?
Because there is no one else to claim them for the deceased.
Mama, you do not know he is deceased. There were no remains.
Well, there wouldn't be now, would there?
Oh, Mama, you know full well the schoolmaster is not deceased. The old captain said he saw a man sure to be Ichabod Crane, alive and well and walking the street in New York just a fortnight ago.
There are many people in New York, Katrina.
Yes, but no one who could possibly be mistaken for Ichabod Crane.
Katrina, why would the schoolmaster leave Sleepy Hollow without so much as a goodbye? No, I say the headless horseman was riding for souls that night, and he found the schoolmaster.
And I say the schoolmaster had a scare and left out of embarrassment. He was a prolific writer. His journal is filled with daily musings. Here is his last journal entry. Interesting.
Oh, what does it say?
When I ride alone at night, I see phantoms of the mind walking in the darkness behind me. But then daylight comes and puts an end to all these evils.
It is true that an old farmer who had been down to New York on a visit several years later brought home news that Ichabod Crane was still alive and that he had left Sleepy Hollow partly through fear of the Headless Horseman and partly in mortification at having been dismissed by Katrina VonTassel. But it is also true that Brom Bones was married to Katrina shortly after his rival's disappearance. And whenever the story of Ichabod Crane was told, Brom Bones would burst into a hearty laugh at the mention of the shattered pumpkin by the bridge. The old country wives, however, are the best judges of these matters, and they maintain to this day that Ichabod Crane was spirited away by supernatural means. The church bridge became more than ever an object of superstitious awe, and many a loitering schoolboy has told of hearing the schoolmaster's voice at the bridge, singing a melancholy hymn on an autumn evening.
You've been listening to The Legend of Sleepy Hollow, an adaptation of the classic Washington Irving story written by Deborah Hanley. The show was directed by Nikki Dobos, with sound engineering by Lester Batts of Sound and Solutions and Martin Clem of Kalamazoo Record. Music was composed by Hal Hobson Morris and performed by Hal Hobson Morris and Brent Decker. Sound effects were provided by Jake Burrell and Gary Brown. This nonprofit performance was performed at the First Baptist Church of Kalamazoo and is copyrighted with all other rights reserved by the author. Any resemblance to persons living or dead or characters, names, places, or incidents is purely coincidental. This is your announcer, Mickey Sykes, thanking you for listening tonight and inviting you to visit us again for another All Ears Theater presentation.